What's good, guys? It's your girl Tink, and I am back with another video. I got another juicy little story time for you guys, and this recently just happened, guys, so this is just a little awareness for y'all, because honestly I don't know what could have happened to me, guys. As y'all could tell by the title of the video, you guys already know what today's video is going to be about. Before we get into this video, make sure y'all hit that subscribe button. It only takes a second. I can wait. All right, let's go. So this happened super recently. Let me just start from the gym, okay? So me and my man was having a good day. Some way, somehow, we got into an argument, okay? And it was the craziest day. I'm not even kidding. Okay, so the first thing that happened to us was my boyfriend, he wanted me to get the keys. And I didn't want to get the keys because I was walking, storming off or whatever. So he drops the keys somewhere and he drives off. When I was doing all that, I saw a couple walking past us, watching us and stuff, and there was a lot of motherfuckers watching us, okay? So the couple was watching us, and as I walk past the couple and the keys are on the floor, the couple picks my keys up, my house keys up, and keeps walking. And luckily, my boyfriend was like turning back around because he saw I was not getting those keys, and I like just had an instinct to just like kind of look back and see what the fuck they were doing, because I felt like they were about to do some dumbass shit too. So I had like turned around, and my boyfriend was also going around the corner. So when he went around the corner, him and the dude that picked up my keys, my house keys, start arguing. They start arguing, and they gave us back the keys. And that was just a little, you know, of what happened. So we had like, you know, conjoined at that point because we were mad at each other. But I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Like, don't be trying to take my keys. Yeah, give us back our keys. And I get in the car and we go in the garage. And we go and we pull into our garage. But we were still furious at each other. Like, we were still pissed. But I still had to have his back because, bitch, no, you're not finna pick up my keys and think you finna just walk off with our keys. Like, are you fucking retarded? I'm right here. And he's right there. Like, we didn't go far. What are you thinking? Of course it was gonna be a problem. That's not why me and my boyfriend was arguing, but that was what happened at the beginning of, like, just a little mini story about a problem I had with somebody else that day. Okay, so now to the juicy stuff. So me and my boyfriend were still arguing when we get in the house, and I'm like, you know, I just couldn't take it that day, so I go and I leave. So I just had on a little hoodie and like my little pants that like flare out at the bottom, and I just left, put my hoodie on and stuff. I was looking so ratchet, so raggedy, and just like looking like I was going through a lot, because I was like so I was going through a lot. So I decided to walk to the dispensary and give me a little motherfucking shit. And that's what I did. So I walked to the dispensary. Gone was cool. I was just walking, and then like in the dispensary I was like, "Carla, can I get this flower, please?" Yeah, that's gonna do me justice right now. And the weed wasn't all that good anyways, because I went to that motherfucking stupid ass dispensary just walking distance from my house. That is the worst mother freaking dispensary. Literally. But yeah, so I got my little weed and I decided to walk like back towards my house. So we have a store like down the street by our house. So that's where I was gonna go, and I had to walk past my house to do that. So, you know, I was thinking everything was good, everything was cool. So I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna grab my little weed, walk to the store, and probably just sit like, you know, somewhere at the park and just chill and smoke my blunt and get my thoughts together. As I'm walking past my building, my house, there's this guy that I see like walking across the street. But he just walks across the street and he stands by a car, and I didn't think nothing of it. I was just walking, you know, I'm trying to just hurry up and go to the store so I could get me a blunt, maybe a little drink, and sit my like ass down. So I see him, I peep him, and I see, like, of course, you know, I'm peeping my surroundings and shit. I see him, I see a couple more other motherfuckers, and like I think that day they were having like a little homeless thing from homeless people, so they were giving homeless people food and stuff, and so there was a lot of people around. So I was just walking and, you know, still in my thoughts, because I was just crying in the dispensary, like just crying in the dispensary. And as I was walking back, I was still crying, like, oh my gosh, people were just staring at me. So he's standing there, he's just doing, like, I don't know what the fuck he was doing. He had like an envelope and like something in the envelope, and he was just messing around with it. And then I walk past, and like all I hear is,
hey, excuse me.
And I'm like, just keep walking. You know, I just kept walking, like, I did not give a fuck. But I felt like somebody was still following me. Like, just in case he wasn't following me, I looked back, like, maybe, like, 50 seconds later, like, and he was still following me. He was just, like, kind of, like, put a pep in his step type of walk after me. Like I said, he had that envelope in his hand, so I thought he was, like, a Jehovah's Witness. So I'm like, okay, he wants to, you know, sell me the Bible, or he wants to sell me something. Like, what the fuck does he want? So I turn around and I'm like, yeah, this is him with the envelope.
Hi.
And I'm like, hi. Like, you know, I kept it cool, kept it smooth, because, you know, I didn't want to reject him. And he, you know, got his homies in his fucking car, and they fucking kidnapped me because, you know, type shit. Like, I didn't want to just be rude to him off the bat. I was just like, hey, like, what you got? Like, what you got in there? Like, he like,
oh, something off of Amazon.
And it was like some shoestrings or some shit. I'm like, okay. And he like,
yeah.
And I'm like, and I was like, about to turn, and then he stepped closer. He was like,
can I get your number?
And I'm like, no. I said, I have a boyfriend. He's like,
oh, well, we can't be friends.
No, I have a boyfriend and a child. Like, he's like,
oh, well, damn, we can't be friends.
And he stepped closer. I'm like, step back, like, no, like. And that around that time, we were like getting close to the people who were just selling the, I'm not selling, giving the homeless the food and stuff. So I'm like walking away, like telling him like, no, you can't. So I like slowly walk away and turn around and head to the store as I usually plan. So as I'm going down, I'm like, okay, yeah, like, you know, like that was kind of weird. You just stepping up to me. I'm still thinking in my head, but so I keep looking back and stuff, and I'm like, coast is clear. He's not following me. He's not walking, like still walking back in the back of me and stuff, so I'm good. So I continue on. Of course, I'm still looking around, but I'm like, you know, I'm good, I'm straight. I think the store is like 3 blocks down from my apartment complex. As I'm like 2 buildings like down from the store building, not even 50 steps, maybe 20 steps down from the store, I turn back, and it's the same dude that was just behind me. This time, he's in a car. I should have saw what kind of car he had, but I know he had like a lift sign on the front of his window, and I don't know what type of car it was. I should have got that down, because a bitch like me needs to be safe out here in these streets. So yeah, he's in the car. He's like,
hey, you need a ride anywhere?
And I'm like, no, I'm right here, like, I'm good. He's like,
are you sure?
I'm like, yes. And I go walk, turn around and walk straight into the store, like, I'm right here, what are you doing? Like, nigga, fuck, I said no already, the fuck. So I go in the store, and I go and I'm looking around for a couple of minutes, because I'm like, when I get out of here, this man better be gone, because what the fuck are you doing? I said no. And I grab me a little Monaco, and I grab me my sticks, because I went to the dispensary. And so yeah, I grab me my sticks, and I slowly walk out the door, and I look around when I'm walking out, and he's gone, coast clear. So I thought, okay, I walk all the way those 3 blocks down back to my house. I wasn't walking far, I was just staying in the area and shit, so I didn't walk far, I wasn't gone far and stuff. So, but it did take me like a little minute to get back to where I needed to go. So about time I went back to where I needed to go, this man should have been gone. I ain't never seen him anywhere around. Like, since I've been here, I never seen him anywhere around. So, like, he should be gone, you know? So, I head back to my complex, and across the street there's a park. And since I was going through so much, I didn't want to be home at that time. So I go to the park and I sit down and I, you know, roll me a blunt, smoke me a blunt, you know, get that popping right there. And I'm sitting there chilling in my feelings and everything, but watching my surroundings because I'm like kind of like my back is towards like somewhere where like nobody could go behind me and snatch my motherfucking black ass up. My front was towards like, because it's only a one way down my street, so literally I was faced where I could just see everybody. Nobody could really see me the way I was sitting. So I do that, and then eventually I get the courage to go back home. When I go back home, because I was like getting wrong for like, you know, what our situation, me and my boyfriend's situation was. So I wanted to go back home and kind of get back on good terms with him. But when I got back home, my man was still on some fuck shit. So guess what? I decided to leave again. But this time, your baby girl was like, let me grab the brown backpack. Because the motherfucker don't want to fuck with me when I got the brown backpack. Okay? So I grab the brown backpack and I head out. And so I go down to the first floor, and as the elevator opens, there's this motherfucking dude standing right there. And I'm like, what the fuck? And I go and I hurry up out of the elevator because like, what the fuck are you doing in my complex? I never seen this man. Well, I probably, you know, I don't fucking know. I never seen this man ever, you know? And like, as I'm heading out the complex, this man grabs me. Grabs my fucking arm. And I said, I gotta go, motherfucker. I gotta go get my child. Like, get the fuck off of me. Oh, and I hurried up and left out of my complex. Like, and I literally was about to catch the bus to my sister, but I called my sister. And I was like, sister, like, this guy was following me and shit. So they zoom, 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 zoom to me. And boom, my sister was there in about 10 minutes. Because she was somewhere, like, with my Yari. And I was like, let me just chill with y'all for the day. And I chill with them for the day. And, yeah, we kicked it. But my night turned out fun, but that was the craziest fucking shit. Like, what are you doing? Like, are you fucking stalking me? Like, I don't know what he was trying to do. I don't know if he was trying to stalk me, but Mr. Sir, if you weren't, and you like me so bad, that bad, I told you no, and no means no. Like, period. Like, I don't want to be friends. I don't want to talk to you.
I don't want to see you, talk to you, kick it with you, skate with you, nothing, man.
None of that. No means no. And that's just that. Like, I said no. So for you to keep following me is motherfucking stalker-like. Like, get your life. That is it for today's video. If you guys like this video, go ahead and give this video a like, comment, and subscribe. And let me know what y'all want to see. Yeah, period.